The battle for honors in the company car park changed with the arrival of family SUVs, because many buyers ditched their conventional saloons and hatchbacks for something with a little more style. But while fleet warfare might be fought in a different way these days, there's still a group of large, practical and tech-filled hatches that's perfect for business people or families wanting affordable transport. None is more cost-effective than Vauxhall's Insignia Grand Sport. But while it has price on its side, it'll have to offer more than just value for money to beat the talented Skoda Superb, which has ruled the roost here for years. In an effort to compete against the growing group of SUVs, Vauxhall has redesigned its Insignia large family hatchback, offering buyers something that's a little more stylish, without sacrificing the car's trademark practicality. In the transformation to the Insignia Grand Sport, the brand has also updated the interior tech to bring the aging previous Insignia bang up to date, placing the model on a level playing field with some of the best cars in the business. At the heart of the matter is the Insignia's usability, and with 490 liters of luggage capacity with the seats up, underneath the load cover, there's masses of space in the Vauxhall. However, this doesn't come at the expense of room inside the cabin. The Grand Sport has a more flowing roofline than its predecessor, and that means access to the rear is slightly more compromised than with the squarer-shaped Superb, but once aboard headroom is plentiful and even taller passengers won't brush the roof. The Skoda Superb is a firm Auto Express favorite, having picked up a hat trick of best family car titles at our new car awards. The combination of space, performance, efficiency and tech is convincing, and in Sportline trim the gloss black grille, window surrounds and 19-inch alloys mean it arguably looks even sportier than its Insignia rival here. While those 19-inch alloys give the Skoda plenty of appeal, they do affect the ride quality. The car isn't as forgiving as the Insignia is. It crashes over bumps more and doesn't have the same absorbent edge on the road. The 760 pounds dynamic chassis control adaptive dampers help negate this a little when in comfort mode, but not to the extent that the Skoda surpasses the Vauxhall for compliance and comfort. The trade-off is that the Skoda is more direct on twisting country routes. The steering is sharper and less spongy than the Vauxhall's, while there's marginally more grip, too, because the Superb controls roll better than the Insignia, which leans a little more through bends.